Next topic of trigonometry is transformations. Transformations is nothing but to learn the sum or difference of two trigonometric functions into products. Okay, and also product change into sum or difference of two trigonometric functions. So we have to see the transformations. First of all, we have to transformations of product into sum or a difference. So, transformations of product into sum or a difference. Okay, here we have to change the product into sum or a difference of angles. So first of all, we have to take two values. For any values A and B, so we have to take these values. We have to write the product into sum or difference. So first of all, 2 sin A cos B. Okay, this is sin A is one term into cos B is another term. These are the product of two trigonometric values is equal to sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. This is the sum of two trigonometric functions. Okay, and the next second one is 2 cos A sin B is equal to sin of A plus B minus sin of A minus B. Here difference of two trigonometric functions. Next, 2 cos A cos B is equal to cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. Okay, and the next last one, 2 sin A and sin B is equal to cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. These are the four important points. These are the, we have to transform product into sum or difference of two trigonometric functions. Okay, let us see how to, this value is equal to sine of A plus B plus sine of A minus B. So first of all, we have to calculate this one. Then similarly, we have to calculate all these type of problems. Okay, so first of all, we have to calculate 2 sin A cos B is equal to sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. Okay, first of all, we have to calculate this one. So here first of all, we have to see this one. Here sin A plus B, this is sin A minus B. Already we know that sin A plus B formula and sin A minus B formula. So we have to take this sum of two values. That means sin A plus B, that here we have to write, consider sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. Okay, here sin A plus B means sin A plus B formula. Already we know that sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. Okay, plus sin A minus B. This is also a known formula. Sin A cos B minus cos A sin B. So here we have to observe these values. Sin A cos B plus sin A cos B plus cos A sin B minus cos A sin B. Here plus cos A sin B and minus cos A sin B will be cancelled. Then the remaining values are, this is 1 plus 1. That means 2 sin A cos b. So therefore 2 sin a cos b is equal to sin a plus b plus sin a minus b. So we have to calculate remaining 3 values same. Okay. Next of all, we have to transform the sum or differences into products. Okay. We have to see this one. So transformation of sum or difference into products. That means already we know the above formula. We have to transform the product into sum or difference. Here we have to transform sum or difference into product. So first of all, we have to take a plus b. We have to already above we know that we have to take a plus b is equal to c and a minus b is equal to d. Okay. We have to take these two equations. We have to calculate a value and b value. So here we have to take, this is the first equation and this is the second equation. We have to calculate these two values. Then we have to find a and b values. So a plus b is equal to c and a minus b is equal to d. So add these two values. Then this is the cancel. A plus a is 2a is equal to c plus d. So a is equal to c plus d by 2. And similarly, these a value is substitute then any equation, we have to find b value. So here we have to find here b is equal to c minus d by 2. So this is the b value and this is the a value. So these values are substitute above 4 formulas. Then we have to find commit the formulas for sum or difference into product. So let us see the formulas. Sin c plus sin d is equal to 2 sin c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2. Okay, next sin c minus sin d is equal to 2 cos c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2 cos c plus cos d is equal to 2 cos c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2 cos c minus cos d is equal to minus 2 sin c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. So observe that these 4 formulas, here c means a plus b and d means a minus b, and c plus d by 2 means a and c minus d by 2 means b. A plus b, this is a minus b, and this is a and this is b. So the above formulas and these 4 formulas are same, but we have to transform the sum or difference into product if these 4 formulas are used, and we have to transform product into product into sum or difference is the above 4 formulas can be used problems. Okay. We have to see some examples of these formulas. Thank you for watching. Next we have to see in this one. Show that cos 27 degrees plus sin 27 degrees divided by cos 27 degrees minus sin 27 degrees is equal to cos 18 degrees. So already we have to solve these type of problems in multiple and submultiple angles. So how to calculate this transformations we use and show that this problem. Okay, first of all we have to take the numerator, that means cos 27 degrees plus sine 27 degrees. So the formulas of transformations are like sine c plus sine d or cos c plus cos d. Here cos 27 plus sine 27 is here. So we have to convert this one into sine. How to convert this one? So for use allied angles formula. So that means we have to write cos 90 degrees minus, which value can be find? 27, 90 minus 63 degrees. Okay, that means 90 minus 63 means 27. Okay, plus the remaining sine will be right, sine 27 degrees. So here cos 90 minus theta means this is the first coordinate. First coordinate, all the trigonometric values are positive values. So here this is the positive value, and from allied angles 90 plus or minus theta, then cos will be changed to sine. That means sine 63 degrees plus sine 27 degrees. Okay, so we have to observe this one. This is sine c plus sine d. Okay, already we know the sine c plus sine d formula. So what is the formula? 2 sine c plus d by 2. Okay, sine c plus sine d means 2 sine c plus d by 2. Cos c minus d by 2. Okay, that means 2 sine, here c plus d means 90 by 2. This is nothing but 45 degrees, and cos 63 minus 27 means cos 36 by 2. 36 by 2 means 2 ones are 2 eight, cos 18 degrees. Okay, so here sine 45 value already we know that, but cos 18 degrees is not known. So we have to write this one. Okay, and also we have to find the denominator also. So we have to write this one, cos 27 degrees plus sine 27 degrees, that equal to, this value is also right, same similarly this one, that means sine, so we have to write this one, cos 90 degrees minus 63 minus sine 27. Okay, this cos 90 minus theta means first coordinate, all the values are positive, and cos will be changes to sine from using allied angles. Sine 63 degrees minus sine 27 degrees. Okay, here this is, we have to observe this one. This is nothing but sine c minus sine d formula. So sine c minus sine d formula already know that. So 2 cos c plus d by 2 sine c minus d by 2. Okay, that means 2 cos 45 degrees sine 63 minus 29 means 36. 36 divided by 2 means 18 degrees. Sine 18 degrees. So sine 45 value is 1 by root 2, and cos 45 value is 1 by root 2. So substitute these values and we have to calculate the above formula. Okay. Consider LHS. So left hand side we have to consider cos 27 degrees plus sine 27 degrees divided by cos 27 degrees minus sine 27 degrees is equal to cos 27 plus sine 27 means this is, so we have to write directly 2 into sine 45 means 1 by root 2 into cos 8 divided by cos 27 minus sine 27 means 2 cos 45 degrees into sine 18 degrees. So 2. Cos 45 degrees means 1 by root 2. Sine 18 degrees. Here 2, 2 cancel. And 1 by 2, root 2, 1 by root 2 cancel. So then finally, cos 18 degrees by sine 18 degrees. But cos by sine means cot. That equal to cot 18 degrees. We have to prove this problem. Thank you for watching. Next problem. If sin x plus sin y is equal to 3 by 4 and sin x minus sin y is equal to 2 by 5, then prove that 8 into tan x plus y by 2 is equal to 15 into tan x minus y by 2. So first of all, we have to given these two values. That means sin x plus sin y is equal to 3 by 4 and sin x minus sin y is equal to 2 by 4. We have to find these two values are equal. Okay, this is proof, this one. So first of all, we have to consider the given values. So sin x plus sin y is equal to 3 by 4 and sin x minus sin y is equal to 2 by 5. Okay, so here we have to write, this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. So we have to take the given values. Given values are sin x plus sin y is equal to 3 by 4 and sin x minus sin y is equal to 2 by 5. We have to write, this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Okay. Now consider equation 1 divided by equation 2. That means sin x plus sin y is equal to 3 by 4 divided by sin x minus sin y is equal to 2 by 5. Okay. Here we have to observe this one. This is sin c plus sin d. Already we know the formula for sin c plus d and sin c minus d. So we have to substitute these formulas. Okay. That means 2 sin x plus y by 2 cos x minus y by 2 divided by 2 cos x plus y by 2 sin x minus y by 2 is equal to, here 3 by 4 divided by 2 by 5. That means 3 by 4 into 5 by 2. Okay. Here 2 and 2 are cancelled. Here sin x plus y by 2 and cos x plus y by 2. Sin by cos means tan x plus y by 2 into, this is cos x minus y by 2, sin x minus y by 2. That means cot x minus y by 2 is equal to, here 3 into 5 means 15 divided by 4 into 2 means 18. So observe the problem. This is 8 into tan x plus y by 2. So tan x plus y by 2 will be here. So we have to take 8 into this side. Okay. And tan 15 into tan x minus y by 2. So here cot x minus y by 2 here. So we have to convert this side. This is nothing but multiplication. That means we have to convert this type divide. That means 1 by cot. 1 by cot means tan. So we have to write 8 into tan x plus y by 2 is equal to 15. Actually 15 divided by cot x minus y 1 by 2. But 1 by cot x minus y by 2 means tan. Okay. Tan x minus y by 2. Hence prove the problem. Okay, thank you for watching.